Thank you for coming today. I'm from Christian Alliance PC Law Memorial International School. We were founded in 1992, so nearly about 30 years in this city, serving children, and we want to develop them to be servant leaders for the future. So we just reopened in 2020, this year in August. We have about 150 children now. Later on, I will show you a little video of like our children at the school. We closed down for renovation in 2017, and we have just reopened. And when we decided what would be the focus on the next leg of our journey, we believe that holistic and bilingual education will be timely and suitable. So that's what we'll be sharing with you today. So, if you have a look, this is our upcoming events in the Abundant Grace dedication ceremony on the 12th of December. We want to dedicate our school because we are a Christian school. We believe that it's good to be thankful for God's provision. As I mentioned, we started in 1992 and we closed in 2017. We have just reopened. So we show you some picture of the renovation work that has taken that took place a while ago. Not only is the outside of the school being renovated, if I take you into the school, if you're interested to come for our information session, then you will get to walk around different parts of the school. First, when you come to the school reception area, you will see that there will be places where the scriptures will be telling us that's what we want to do. Our school motto is to have children and all the people who come to the school to be the example in speech and behavior, in faith, in love, and in purity. And our direction is to train the children in the way they should go, and so when they get older, they will not turn from the way. This is a photos of our children coming to school, and they get the hand gel, sanitizer, and then the temperature check. And then when you come to the covered play space that we have covered play space, outdoor play space, and indoor play space, you will see that we purposely have games that will help them to either learn the phonics program or the penguin program. We have the outdoor play space where children get to move around a lot. We also have a lot of time during the day where children will have recesses and also activity in the outdoor setting. This is our classroom, and the EDB requires that we have to have the classroom set in such a way now because of COVID season that they have to all face in the front. But we still use a food pot in place of a replacement of the carpet so children can actually sit in groups and also provide the social distancing when there is group setting work. Our assembly hall and also the indoor play space. And inside, we would have places where children can gather for worship. And also, there would be time when they have a snack and lunch in the school. We have the Heavenly Studios as a place where children will praise God with music and movement. And the library is a place we call the Treehouse Libraries because we emphasize on children with the theme of the forest, a place for them to appreciate diversity, a place to explore, and a place to discover together. We also have a maker space. It's a place where we believe that children have to use their hands to build things and testing them out because it's from the imagination to realization. It's a time for them to build the confidence. So this is our school logo, and this school logo also has the philosophy of education of CAPCL, where we believe bilingual and holistic education is very important. The Bible says, blessed is the person who is planted by the streams of water. He will be like a tree planted by the streams of water, which yields its fruit in season. His leaf will not wither. Whatever he does, prosper. We believe that children need to know where they are grounded. Building a good foundation is very important. The fruits will come in its seasons, which means that parents and educators have to be very patient. At the same time, our job is to provide the condition for growth. But children, their leaf will not wither. Whatever they do, they prosper. They have to be productive, useful. Even though when the fruits are not there, they should be active servant leaders in the society. We think that holistic education encompasses four domains. We may often focus on the head and the hands. What children are learning at school, what can they do? What are they showing in the report cards? But we believe holistic is more than what you can see. There are parts you don't see underground. It's the heart, which is the motive and the reason for doing things, their desires. The Bible said, guard your heart, it is the wellspring of your life. At CAPCL, one thing we want children to learn is don't hurry in getting things done. Because they often get, you know, hurried up by parents or other people because they have to get things done quickly. The timetable is fully packed. But we believe that children need to slow down and to think why they do what they do. And having the right reason for doing what they do. Guard the heart, because that's the wellspring of the life. Even when they're young, they think about why they do what they do is very important. Same go with the habits. Building good habits is very important. We also tell them it's also from the Bible. The Bible said you can build a house on the rock, which takes a lot of time. You can build a house on the sand, which is very easy and you can play because it's by the beach. But when the storm comes, one will last, the other will not. We want children to do things thoroughly so that they will be able to be faithful and fruitful. So these are the four domains that our teachers are focusing on in day-to-day, from the time they come to school to the time that they leave, that we will talk to them a lot about why are you doing things, guarding your heart. What are the habits our children building in the, throughout the whole school day? And that is what we wanted to do. Now, this is our school campus. Maybe instead of me saying a lot of things, let you have a look at a virtual campus tour.
attention span。中西文化有好多嘅嘢我哋可以学习，当佢哋喺学习语言嘅时间，亦可以明白到佢背后文化嘅唔同。当一个小朋友对中西文化都有认识同欣赏嘅时候，佢哋第日无论面对咩嘅环境嘅改变，佢哋咧都会更加容易去适应，同埋会欣赏别人，令到佢哋嘅社交能力亦会有进步。我哋學校裏面有五科嘅主科，當中有中文、英文、數學、Science 同 Social Studies。除咗五科嘅主科之外，我哋仲有五科嘅 Specialty Subjects， 當中會有美術科啦、音樂科啦、體育科、 聖經科同埋健康科。我哋好希望咧，小朋友喺學校裏邊學習嘅過程當中咧，佢可以鍛鍊到中文同英文嘅繪畫、聆聽、閱讀同寫作嘅能力。
小朋友在國際學校可以學到終身語文和國際視野真的很重要，同時學校也都兼顧全人發展。
我們很希望我們的學校是一個培養學生的地方，我們可以再培養我們的學生，除了品學兼優之外，是會成為將來的國人領袖，他們用他們所學的去貢獻社會，服侍其他人。在我們的學校裏面，我們很希望小朋友是互相的了解、認識和彼此的服侍，我們要求他們無論在學校和家裡都成為我們的基督小使者。基督小使者的新的裝束就令他們記得我們很需要知道什麼是真和假，這個就是他們真理的腰帶，亦要知道什麼是對和錯，這個就是公義的護心鏡。他們除了有救恩的頭盔之外，還有帶著平安福音的鞋，希望他們去到哪裡都將平安的福音告訴其他人知。做事需要有信心，他們身上要有一個有信心的盾牌，以及象徵神話語的寶劍，神的話語帶給他們有智慧，令到他們面對將來的問題的時候，他們都能夠跨過。所以當小朋友見到我們的基督小使者，會令他們記得他們的 meaning， 以及呢更加明白他們的意思和產生的聯繫。我們呢在我們學校裏面有一個金句，說教養小朋友行方向的路，到他們大了他們都不會偏離。我們很想我們的小朋友是學行一條感恩的路，因為我們知道小朋友懂得怎樣去感恩，他們就會找到喜樂，這個是一個很有意義的學習家。So, when we talk about, we have 65% of time we're learning in English, 35% of time is in Chinese, and I mean Mandarin and traditional script. How is that being divided?In the morning, they come in about 8 o'clock, and then they finish at 3:30. And Chinese is being taught in Mandarin. Mathematics is taught bilingually, which means that the textbooks will be in English, and the teaching, the listening, and the conversation is all in Mandarin. And you think that in this way, will children actually have a hard time because they have to read something in English, they have to listen into something that is Mandarin? But we believe over time, it actually helps children to develop their attention span, paying attention to detail, as well as expand their problem-solving skills, just because the language is being a medium where they have to learn the mathematics. We also teach the specialty subject. There are 5. 1 out of the 5 will be in Mandarin. The other 4 will be in English. The reason we are doing that, and it is done by semester, is that we want to teach children the culture, not by reading from a book, but their own personal experience. You can see, when you go to a Chinese church, you listen to the music. You go to an international church, an English church, you listen to the music. They are both praising God, but then they use very different melodies. And we think that when children learn culture through music, through creation of art, through sport, they learn it in such a way it is fun. It's very important that children enjoy what they learn. And if I teach them, my Canadian teachers will teach them how to play floor hockey. And then we'll explain to you in Canada, Alberta is very cold, we play ice hockey. It's very different than teaching them how to do martial arts. We taught them about baseball, and we teach them about basketball. When we're doing it this way, we actually infuse a lot of cultural values into the learning. Why bilingual education? Many people think, oh, that is because you want them to be fluent in two languages. Actually, there are many more benefits other than just language proficiency. Learning two languages that are very different
have a lot of challenges, but over time, we train children to be more resilient in overcoming challenges. They become more creative in problem solving. They are more confident when they actually go to places where there are lots of changes. We think children who learn in two languages, they are better global citizens. There are also actual research to say that when children, they are systematically learning two languages over time, they have improvement in the intellectual potentials, in the scholastic achievement, as I mentioned, that also due to the fact that when they learn two languages that are very different, it expands their memory bank, as well as helping them to focus better in the learning. And also, it will give them a way of improving the lateral thinking skills. I can say to you that in Canada, just in the city of Edmonton, which is in Alberta, there are over 20 schools that are bilingual, English and Chinese schools. Now, Canada has two official languages, French and English. So I'm not talking about French and English, I'm talking about bilingual, 50%, 50%. English and Chinese schools. They also have bilingual Tagalog and English schools. They also have Punjabis and English schools because they believe when children are learning two languages, it is improving their learning ability and is important for children's growth. So what I'm trying to say is that there's so many schools over many years are doing bilingual Chinese and English schools, so we think this is actually a very workable way. Now, I think the time is running out, so I just quickly mention, in Alberta or Canada education, especially in elementary, we are not concerned so much on how much knowledge children can remember. We know that they have to learn how to read, their literacy, as well as how to write, and also how to do the mathematics, but the concern is on the competence wheel, meaning that while they're learning how to read, how to write, and how to do the mathematics, we want them by the time they finish elementary schools to develop these competence that they're able to look at the, they're able to use technology wisely. We want them to be able to learn on their own. That means if they have to find out something, do they have the skill set to look for the answers themselves? They're able to say they can work with others, and in a group setting, if they're being picked to be the leader, they're able to lead the group discussion. We want to see children, if given the projects to do, whether they can list out the factors for evaluation. Can they solve problems instead of only identify their problem and waiting teachers to provide answers? Can they make good decisions? And I think that goes in the play-based learning because sometimes you can see children have two actions. When they see somebody come to them and creating a problem, they can either go to the teacher and expect teachers to solve it, or they can try to solve it themselves. We don't want them to just identify the problem. We want them to solve the problem. We want them to be creative and innovative. And that comes when the teaching method doesn't only focus on one correct answer. We want children to learn that there are multiple ways to learn, and there could be multiple answers to one question or one problem. And that's what we are realizing is important for children's learning. We want them to be responsible, not just about themselves, but their environment, the globe, the world, their culture, and the society. And lastly, mentioned about communication, because you thought, oh, of course, you're talking about bilingual education. But I'm saying it's not about language only. Communication is more than the language. And if you look at the framework of learning in the Alberta or a Canada setting, you can see if someone who actually know how to find information, how to work with others, how to lead the group, how to solve the problem, the way they communicate will be communicating with wisdom. And that's what we want children to become. Holistic education, bilingual education, ultimately is helping children to communicate with others. The way communicating comes is not just about speaking, it's so much about listening and also solving the problem involving other people. So in our schools, we have three R's, we have three P's, and we have three E's. And I think that kind of sums up what I want to share with you today about bilingual and holistic education. We want learning to be relevant. We want learning to be rigorous. And more important, we want learning to be relational. It's important that children learn socially with others because relationship is what they remember. Can you remember what you learned when you were grade 5 in the first week of school? You probably don't remember very clearly, but you might remember a few people who have made an impact in your life, and that's because the relationship is there. So we want learning that is bilingual and holistic to be relevant, to be rigorous, as well as relational. We also want to see three P's in our schools. You can look at the children's face. We want it to be play. We want them to participate. We want to have many possibilities. The reason for that is when children choose to play, they participate. They become active in the learning instead of passively being pushed to do things. And lastly, it's important that we have to be open-minded, letting them to create different possibilities. Holistic and bilingual education has to be engaging. It has to be ethical. Holistic education is talking about, it's not just about the knowledge, but use the knowledge to serve other people, guarding your heart, building good habits. This is about being ethical and also using it to benefit the world, being entrepreneurial. So holistic education, bilingual education, also encompassed into being engaging, ethical, and entrepreneurial. So this is what I would like to share with you. Our booth is on the number 9 outside. You can have a look. If you're interested to find out about our school and come to see our school, you can check out the admission tab in the website, and then you can book a time to come to our school and have a visit. So that's part of my sharing. So if you have any questions, you can ask, and I'll try my best to answer before the session is over. Do you have any questions? Great. Well, thank you so much for being very attentive today, and I hope that you enjoy the rest of your visit today. Thank you.